हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. दिस इज़ एच डी पवार, लेक्चरर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, गोपटे पीयू कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, बेलगाम. इन द फिफ्थ पार्ट ऑफ परफेक्ट कॉम्पिटिटिव मार्केट, लेट अस डील विद द क्वेश्चन, एक्सप्लेन द शॉर्ट रन, दैट इज एस आर, शॉर्ट रन सप्लाई कर्व ऑफ अ फर्म. टू डिराइव द शॉर्ट रन सप्लाई कर्व and determine the maximizing output level, that is Q0, here the SAVC, the short run average variable cost, is the deciding or determining factor of the supply curve in the short run, and AC is the deciding, average cost is deciding factor of supply curve in the long run. We are going to deal both with short run supply curve and long run supply curve. Here in the short run, the SAVC is the deciding factor. So the conditions are the same. You have to write down the condition. That is, first let us deal with if price is greater than or equal to AVC, what will happen? It is going to be profits. And if price is less than or equal to AVC, is what? It is going to show loss. If price is less than AVC, it will show loss. So let's deal with the first case. If price is greater than AVC, what will happen? Now both the cases, first one and second one, that is when price is greater than AVC, and second when price is less than AVC, we are going to show in the same diagram. Okay, in the same diagram we are going to show. Just look at the diagram. On x-axis we are showing the output, on y-axis we are measuring price. Now here see, P1 denotes the price of first case when price is greater than AVC. So here you see P1 is the price line, and below P1 you see SAVC curve. You see the SAVC curve, which is below the price line P1. So that denotes when the average variable cost is less and price is greater than SAVC, then it denotes what? Profit. Okay, the conditions are the same here. The marginal cost, that is price, has to be equal to MC. Then MC has to be non-decreasing at Q0, and third condition, price has to be greater than or equal to minimum of AVC. Now first two conditions will be satisfied. It is only the third condition, that is the price has to be greater than AVC, is the deciding factor. Therefore you see here, first condition is fulfilled, that is price is equal to marginal cost at a point A, where price P1 cuts the marginal cost SMC curve at a point A, where P is equals to AR is equals to MR, we have shown. Then second point, at where P1 is equal to SMC, there the SMC is rising upwards, so we get equilibrium output Q0. But here we haven't mentioned, it is not shown Q0, but it is written Q1. Why? Because second condition also we are showing here, which denotes losses. So Q is the maximizing equilibrium output at a point A, and second condition, SMC curve is non-decreasing, that is it is moving upwards, it is increasing. The third condition, price has to be greater than equal to AVC, is also satisfied, because see, the price line P1 is greater than the minimum of AVC. Then so here AVC is the shutdown point and also the starting point of supply curve. See below the point, below the minimum of SAVC, where the curve marginal, just see here, when the marginal cost curve is moving upward, it touches the minimum of SAVC first, that is the minimum point. So then when it from above the SAVC, the SMC curve moves, that is also called as the supply curve of the firm. That is also called as what? Supply curve of the firm. It is shown in darker shade. You just see the SMC curve is coming from below, which is a thin line. Then after cutting the SAVC, minimum of SAVC, it is moving upwards. From that point, SMC curve is also called as the supply curve. Therefore, AVC is a very deciding, AVC is a deciding factor of a firm, where it shows that it is also the starting point of the supply curve. AVC is shutdown point and also the starting point of a supply curve. In the diagram at P1, you just see P1, the three conditions are satisfied at a point A. MC is not decreasing at output level Q0, and MC is equals to price P1 at a point A. Then price at a point A only, P1 is greater than the minimum of average variable cost where the firm earns profits. When price is greater than the cost, then profits are earned by the firm. Then second condition, second case we are showing, if price is less than AVC. Here we show in the same diagram at a point P2, price line P2 is shown. Firm produces zero output as it does not satisfy any conditions and price is less than minimum of AVC. And for all the prices strictly below minimum of AVC is a shutdown point. Okay, just see here, price line is shown here, P2 price line is shown, and it does not satisfy any condition, that is the marginal cost curve is not cutting the price line P2, then and also the price line P2 is below the average variable cost. The average variable cost is much above and above the P2, so here none of the conditions are satisfied. So it is here the firm will not produce any output because it is not able to recover any costs. It is not able to recover even the average variable cost. So that point is called as a shutdown point. Shutdown point means what? Where the firm is not able to the firm is not able to recover even the average variable cost, that is like raw materials, or it is not even able to pay the regular or daily wages of the laborers, then it is called as a shutdown point. Then explain the long run supply curve of a firm. Here also it is the same explanation, only here instead of AVC curve you are only taking LAC, average cost curve, because in the long run, as you know, there are no variable cost and fixed cost, all the costs are variable only. Okay, there is no fixed or variable, but all the cost becomes a variable cost. It is just average cost. Explain the long run supply curve. Explain the long run supply curve of a firm. To derive the long run supply curve, average cost, AC, is the determining factor or the deciding factor. Here again in the diagram, same diagram except AVC curve is missing here. At P1, both we are showing both the conditions, when price is greater than average cost and when price is less than average cost. At a price line P1, output is what? Q1. And it satisfies all the three conditions, that is the
price line P1 is equals to the marginal cost at a point A. Again, first condition is satisfied. Then at a point A or equilibrium output Q0, the marginal cost is non-decreasing, that is, it is moving upwards. And the third condition, what is the third condition? Price has to be greater than the minimum of average cost in the long run. That is, you see, price line P1 is above, it is greater, and the minimum of LAC is below. So here clearly it shows, therefore, the profits are gained by the firm. I'll just read it. Price is equals to LMC at A. MC is rising and price is greater than minimum of LAC. Therefore, profits and the supply continue. Okay, production takes place. So, supply continues and profits also continue in the form of marginal cost. As MC above AVC, you see below the point, MC is a curve which is coming from below and moves upwards, but above the minimum of AVC in a darker color, it is shown that MC above the AVC is also the supply curve of the firm. It is also the supply curve of the firm. The MC above the minimum of AVC is MC curve as well as the supply curve of the firm. At a point P2, at a price line P2 is shown here, the firm produces zero output as it does not satisfy any of the conditions. It is not able to recover the costs, so it will discontinue the production and there will be zero output, and hence that is also called as a shutdown point of the firm, where it totally stops the production and it will quit the industry. Let's see, there will be a question, what is a shutdown point? A firm produces as long as price is greater than or equal to minimum of average variable cost in the short run. Okay, the price has to be greater than the average variable cost in the short run. It means if price is less than the minimum of AVC, the firm is not able to recover the variable costs. Okay, I just told you recover the variable cost means it is not able to pay the electricity bill, it is not able to recover the fuel charges, it is not able to recover the wages that are being, daily wages that are being paid to the workers. Okay. So, if it is not able to recover the daily costs also, then it is time that the firm decides not to produce the goods, and it is called shutdown point. That is, it will close down the firm. The AVC is the shutdown point as well as starting point of the supply curve. As I have showed you, the marginal cost comes from below, cuts the minimum of AVC. So, and above AVC, the MC curve moves, which is MC curve as well as the supply curve of the firm. You just need to write, a firm produces as long as the price is greater than minimum of AVC in the short run. And in case of long run, what? The price has to be greater than minimum of average cost, AC. In short run, AVC, and in long run, AC, because they are the deciding factors. And if the price is below the minimum of AVC in the short run and price is below the minimum of AC in long run, then it is what? That means it is not able to recover the cost, and therefore the firm will decide not to produce the goods, and this point is called as shutdown point. Now, there are concepts like normal profits, supernormal profits, or abnormal profit we call it as, and break-even points. They can come for 1 or 2 marks. Just see what is normal profits. Normal profit is zero profit level that is just enough to cover the cost of the firm. It is when the difference between total revenue and total cost is zero. That is, the firm is continuing in the industry and it is neither making profits nor it is making loss. The TR and TC are zero. The difference between TR and TC is zero. It is just able to recover the cost, and it is the minimum level of profit needed for a firm to remain in the market. See, every day it cannot earn profits. So if it has to exist in the industry, it will make a normal profit. That is, it is just able to recover the cost and be in the industry. It is the minimum level of profit needed for a firm to remain in the market. Maybe after some time it will start earning again profit. Okay, immediately it will not quit the industry. So normal profits are at least required to sustain or to exist or to remain in the industry. Then what is supernormal profits, or it is also called as abnormal profits? Supernormal or abnormal profits are the profits earned over and above the normal profits. They are the profits above the normal profits. That is, they are able to make profits. TR minus TC, that is, here TR will be greater than the TC, supernormal profits. Break-even point, BEP in short, is the point on the supply curve at which the firm earns only normal profits. It is like normal profits only, that is break even point. Neither there is profit, the firm is neither making profits nor it is incurring loss, where TR, total revenue, is just equal to the total cost. So I hope you have understood the concepts, that is the supply curve of a firm in the short run as well as the long run. We have explained both the short and long run, taking two cases. That is, first case, when price is greater than AVC, and if price is less than AVC in the short run, and when price is greater than AC and price is less than AC in the long run. So for today, we shall stop. Thank you.